Organization Committee, Government Organization Committee, and the chairman of the ICT Committee. Thank you so much for the early calendaring of this bill. Mr. Chairman, I am sponsoring House Bill number 16 on the creation of the Department of Information and Communications Technology. As you can see from the number, this is one of the first bills to be filed. And I think this will indicate the kind of priority that this representation is giving to this House bill. At the same time, Mr. Chairman, I also would like to inform the body that I got a call from the Honorable Luis Villafuerte, and he asked me to also sponsor for him on his behalf his own House Bill number 64, which I think is almost identical to my House Bill. Mr. Chairman, as mentioned by the chairman of the ICT committee, the ICT sector is already a huge sector. That by itself is already an overwhelming justification for the creation of the DICT. But it is not just the static size, snapshot size of the ICT sector that's important. What is more dramatic is how it is accelerating. It is growing at an exponential rate. And I think in a number of a few years, as already stated, the $10 billion BPO sector, almost $10 billion, can overtake the much appreciated OFW sector, which is growing at a very moderate rate. We're talking of 20, 30, even a higher percent in growth rate. I'd like to show very quickly, just for the record, so that when it comes to plenary, Mr. Chairman, the chairman of the two committees, they'll see that we gave this a very thorough evaluation and consideration. I'm going to use some slides that I got from the CICD, that I got from my own research, and I got from the distinguished chairman of the ICD. We have the BPO sector, which is growing at a rapid rate. The last report I got, it's already 500,000. The last SONA of the former president said that as of the end of 2010, it will reach 600,000 employees. Then we have the telecommunications industry, the fixed lines, but the more dramatic mobile subscriber sector that is, I think, already past 70 million subscribers. But in spite of this high growth, there's still a lot of work to be done. Internet penetration is still very low compared to our neighbor countries, compared to the world. PC penetration is still very low. Broadband penetration, it's still very low. In fact, it's primitive compared to the broadband sectors of the other country. We have the BPO IT industry in terms of annual revenue. The segment, it's not just call centers, but we're fast penetrating the fields of animation, engineering, transcription, back office, and of course, very impressively, software. But what is more impressive is how we stand in the world. We are number three in the world, according to the presentation of the CICT. I cannot think of any other sector, a high-tech sector, where we can claim to be number three in the world. India is, of course, number one. Canada is second, but we are not a far number three. And we are growing. I think India is starting to notice us. We have Facebook, of course. We're number seven in the world as far as Facebook is concerned, growing at a very fast rate. And I talked of exponential. Here I borrowed the PowerPoint of our distinguished chairman of the ICT. 38 years for 50 million users for radio, 13 years for television to reach 15 million, 4 years only for the internet, and 3 years for iPad to reach 50 million, and 9 months for Facebook to reach 50 million users. We are one of the Facebook centers of the world. But I'd like to go back to another very important indicator, and that is the Philippine Cyber Corridor. I'm very happy that we have some guests from many places here, when we speak of the IT sector, it's not just Metro Manila. Of course, Metro Manila is on top of it right now, but we have Metro Cebu, we have Metro Clark as centers of excellence, and we have the new age cities, Davao, Santa Rosa, Bacolod, Iloilo, Metro Cavite, Lipargan, De Oro, Malolos, Baguio, and Dumaguete. Now, going back to the exponential rate, let me show you also my own research, and I borrowed this from the very famous book, The Singularity is Near, by my favorite guru on IT, on the future of computers, Ray Kurzweil. And you can see that the telephone took a while to reach one-fourth of the U.S. population, radio took a while, television was fast, but we have the dramatic growth as far as the PC, more so in the case of the mobile phones and more so in the case of the web. But something that we must really prepare for is the exponential growth in the power of the computer. The singularity is near, is talking of the singularity, when there will be a convergence of the power of the human mind and the power of the computer, where eventually it will be almost indistinguishable. So we are approaching that. It's a big industry. And in order to prepare for this, the single chairman of the two committees, it is a must that we create the Department of Information and Communications Technology. This is going to send a signal to the world that we have arrived, and although we have arrived already, we are preparing further to become one of the leaders of the world insofar as ICT is concerned. There are so many groups that are supporting this initiative, but let me quote what I consider one of the most telling and probably one of the most eloquent endorsement of the creation of the Department of Information and Communications Technology, and this is the Management Association of the Philippines, the premier management organization of the country. They gave they issued a statement September 13, 2 weeks ago, and they're questioning, is there a government agenda on ICT? Of course, this question is being addressed to the executive branch, but if they ask the House of Representatives, of course the answer is yes, there is a government agenda on ICT. And I would like to quote their final paragraph in their statement, and I quote, ICT has become the